Hello and welcome to the 3D quality inspection tools with LMS4000 and SIM2x00 video in the Signova series. In this tutorial, I will show you how you can measure the height and inspect the correct stacking of carton boxes on a pallet using LMS4000 and Signova in just a few simple steps. In the previous installation and image acquisition on LMS4000 and SIM2x00 video, I have mounted and configured all components to capture great 3D data of the pallet. I recommend to watch this video before continuing. My laptop is connected to the Ethernet port 1 of the SIM2x00 running the Signova sensor app. To access the user interface, open a web browser like Google Chrome and enter the default IP address 192.168.0.1. First, let's capture a 3D image of the pallet with its maximum load and perfect alignment. In my case, two levels of carton boxes. Looks great. To use this image as the basis to apply the analysis tools on, click Update Reference below the live image. You will automatically switch to the Reference tab. Now I want to locate the pallet itself in case its position varies. To do so, find the Analysis section on the left, select Add Tool, Locate, and then Object Locator. Move and adjust the tool region to just include the visible front portion of the pallet. In my application, this area will always be empty. Switch to 3D view, rotate to a front view, and move the bottom of the object locator region just above the conveyor belt. To reliably detect the edges of my low profile pallet, find the settings section on the right and change the edge strength value to 5 mm. Let's measure the height of the carton box stack. This value will vary depending on the container type, and is used to optimize storage space and to avoid collisions. Add analysis on the left, select Add Tool indented below Object Locator, choose Measure, and then Min-Max. All indented tools are linked to the outdented tool above and follow its position. Switch to 2D view and adjust the tool region to be slightly smaller than the pallet. Scroll down to the Results section to see the measured values. For my height measurement task, the maximum height value is perfect. Here, you could set expected values with tolerances for your pallet height to get a pass or fail result. To always get a pass result of the tool, I set the tolerances to 1000 mm and just use the actual maximum height value further. Now, let's inspect the correct stacking of the carton boxes to avoid issues during storage or transport. First, we need to find the top surface of the stack as a reference for further inspection. Select Add Tool indented below Object Locator, choose Shape, and then Plane Fitter. In 2D view, adjust the tool region to be slightly smaller than the outer edges of the carton box stack. To account for some unevenness of my carton boxes, find the Settings section on the right and enable the See Offset parameter. Set its value to -20 to virtually move the plane a bit down. Switch to 3D view to see the found plane displayed in blue, a bit below the top surface. Second, I want to search for parts of unknown shape sticking out of the stack. Therefore, select Add Tool indented below Object Locator, Count and Find, and then Blob Finder. Switch to 2D view and adjust the tool region to match the pallet size. Switch to 3D view, rotate to a side view, and move the bottom of the tool region above the pallet. Find the Settings section on the right, change the direction to Down, and the reference plane to Plane Fitter Plane. Now, the Blob Finder will check for areas located between the top of my stack and the pallet, indicating a misalignment. As I only want to identify critical misalignments, I change the minimum area value to 3000. So any area larger than 3000 square millimeters will be evaluated as a blob. Scroll down and find the number of blobs in the Results section. It states 0 found blobs. To use this value as a pass-fail criteria, simply change both the lower and upper limit to 0. So only if no blobs are found, the results will be pass. Any other number will result in a fail. As all tools are configured, let's visualize the results in the dashboard of Signova. Switch to Dashboard in the top left. By default, the overall result and the 2D view are already displayed. To add the height information, click Add Widget in the top right corner. Select Result and confirm with Add. In the Configure Widget window, change the result to Min-Max in the left drop-down and max height in the right dropdown. To state what this value represents, I enter height in millimeters as the title. Confirm with OK. Here you can customize the dashboard to your needs. Now that everything is set up, let's verify that it works as expected. Switch to run in the top right corner and move a flawless stack past the sensor. Once the new 3D image is evaluated, you can see that the overall result is a pass and the height measures 489 mm. In case an entire layer of my stack is rotated, the result fails. The same happens if only one carton box is sticking out. With a correctly stacked pile of containers of a different height, I again receive a pass. Amazing! Who would have thought 3D quality inspections of larger objects could be that easy? If you can't wait to get started, get in touch with your local SIG sales representative now to find out more about the incredible world of SIGNOVA.